We're all in this together. You need to remember that. I think more than any time in my career, our politics have become so mean, so petty, so negative, so partisan, so angry, and so unproductive, so unproductive. Instead of debating our opponents, we demonize them. Instead of questioning judgment, we question their motive. Instead of listening, we shout.
Instead of
looking for solutions, we look to score political points. No more. No more. This politics is pulling apart. It is ripping this country apart at the seams. Our politicians, our politics today, traffics in division. And our president is the divider in chief. Look, he's not the only one, far from it. He's just the worst practitioner of politics that singles out, scapegoats, and demonizes. He holds out the other as the source of all their problems. You hear it. The immigrant, the Muslim, anyone different in creed, color, conviction. They're the problem. That's what he said. That's been the scheme used by unscrupulous politicians for decades. But it comes at a gigantic cost. I mean this from the bottom of my heart. It comes at a gigantic cost. It weakens us. It distracts us. It divides us. It causes us to lose credibility around the world. No, it fixes the wound, and it solves nothing. This is not who we are. This is not who we are. And I absolutely refuse. We need a president who's going to lead, who will insist on dramatic change for the sake of our program. Well, let me tell you something. The single most important thing we have to accomplish to get this done, the single most important thing we have to accomplish is defeat Donald Trump. Trump does. Trump said there's a moral equivalence. Are we a nation that believes ripping children from the arms of their parents at the border? No, we don't. But Trump does. Are we a nation that embraces dictators and tyrants like Putin and Kim Jong-un? No, we don't. But Trump does. Look, every day we're reminded about this in this election about we have to remember who we are. What we stand for, what we believe. And every day we're reminded there's nothing guaranteed.